What I'm going to talk about here is just examining your bumper buoy for proper servo alignment. And what we mean by alignment is that when your servo is mounted, the arm should always return to the correct position. And if you take a look at this servo, you'll see what the correct position is. More importantly, though, is to look at the bumper buoy itself. And if you look in here, you'll see that there's a gap of at least an eighth of an inch. When the unit is uncocked, and when you cock the unit, the lever comes up. And it's very important that this continues to be an eighth of an inch. If it isn't, what happens is that the servo, if we just push it manually like this, where there's no gap, you'll find that when you try to cock it, it won't cock because the lever is not allowed to go out. So a common problem of not cocking is bad servo alignment. And bad alignment is usually caused by either a bad servo or a loose wiring harness. So those are the two things that you should check. One, make sure that your wiring harness is plugged into the main unit. That's the first issue to check. Next would be to examine where the servo comes in the wiring harness and make sure that it has been pulled apart. And the third would be, obviously, a servo which is going bad would cause bad alignment, right? There are ways, if you look in the manual, to readjust this alignment to make sure that you have enough gap. And a servo which doesn't return to the right gap may partially cock the unit, or you may not be able to cock it at all. And you certainly don't want a unit that's partially cocked, because what may happen is when the shell goes off, the recoil may knock the other one off, and it actually acts like double firing. Okay, so I think you can look in the manual and you'll see that you can drive the servo and you'll see that it returns to a certain position. And that's how you check it. You use the electronics to make sure that it returns to the correct position. Anyhow, that's a little tip on servo alignment. This should be done at any time when you're replacing a new servo or just examining your units on a day-to-day basis. Make sure that gap's there.